The Ferrari 458, in its convertible form, especially out here on this pristine countryside, might well be the ultimate expression of the car maker's art and the embodiment of why I love cars. It's fast, its body is both beautiful and functional. Just looking at the car, not to mention driving it, awakens a deeper, more primal place full of passion, jubilation, and a smidge of fear. Frankly, I could end the review there. But I should probably give you the whole story, so let me start at the beginning. This is the first Ferrari I ever drove. It's a 1977 308, and when I was 5, rolling this around on the kitchen floor next to my mother's feet, I thought this is as close as I'd ever get to driving a real Ferrari. Even though I loved this thing perhaps more than my own parents, I didn't really know about it. I didn't understand the difference between this and a race car. I thought a Ferrari was something you could win a race in and then simply drive home. And you know what? I was right.
When it comes to the majestic Ferrari 458 Spider, it can be hard to tell where the racing technology ends and the road tech begins.
The first thing I noticed stepping into the 458 was the steering wheel. Looks like it could have come off an F1 car. In fact, some of it did, like these lights up here that illuminate as it nears redline. The whole car was designed to create a symbiotic relationship between driver and car. Accordingly, everything a driver could need is close at hand here on the steering wheel. Horns, turn signals, lights, wipers, start button. And this switch down here, with every click, turns up suspension stiffness and ratchets down the intervention of the traction control. It's not to be used by the faint of heart, which is why I will not be touching it.
Unlike the dash of other supercars, the 458 has no centralized infotainment screen. Instead, two screens directly in front of the driver flank the centralized tachometer. Branching out from there, we see a very beautifully sculpted dash wrapped in leather, accented by air vents inspired by the exhaust chimneys of F1 cars of the early 2000s. All those switches and buttons aside, we come to the feature that separates this car from all the others, the roof switch. Hold this and the 458 goes from hardtop to spider in 14 seconds, which makes it the world's first mid-rear engine supercar with a retractable hardtop.
And once the roof is all neatly folded away, this glass windstop that Ferrari calls generous rises into an optimal position, allowing for conversation to be comfortably held at 125 miles an hour. I have no doubt that it works, but generous? I'd hate to see what Ferrari calls stingy. Sitting right behind me is some more F1-inspired tech, a naturally aspirated 4.5-liter V8 that makes 558 horsepower and 398 pound-feet of torque. All that power is routed down to the rear wheels through a 7-speed dual-clutch F1 transmission. All told, this 3,153-pound supercar will do 0 to 60 in just under 3.4 seconds and onto a top speed of 202. Now, Ferrari brags the shift time between gears on this dual-clutch F1 transmission is zero. And when I heard that at first, I didn't believe them. Out here, though, I do. There's fourth. There's fifth. There's sixth. My God, this thing is quick!
As I hammer it around the track, all that noise and fury is coming from three exhaust pipes. While the look was designed to conjure memories of the F40, the sound was designed specifically for the Spider to, as Ferrari puts it, completely captivate occupants.
And I'd say it worked! It sounds like a hive of Africanized bees being shoved through a wood chipper. Listen to that! Oh, and it revs to 9,000 RPM, so that means you get more of that sound! God, it revs like a sport bike on bath salts! Ah! I'm gonna eat your face!
The 458 is brilliant on the track, but we already expected that. So what's it like on the open road?
Oh, this is lovely.
Rather than take it to Spain, I've brought the Ferrari out to the Columbia River Gorge, the kind of place I imagined the designers were dreaming of at night, while they created the 458 Spider. Just an hour east of Portland, the land out here is home to vineyards and family farms. And right now, I can think of nothing better than to echo this serene land with the sounds of a furious Ferrari.
It is so direct and so communicative, and there's good reason for that. The suspension is 35% stiffer and the steering 30% more direct than the F430 it replaces. This car feels like it changes direction like a spider. You never feel like you're wrestling the 458, like it's overpowering you. Instead, you feel like you're wearing it, like it's an extension of you. I've driven many, many supercars, but nothing felt quite like this.
The engine isn't the only story with the 458 Spider. The body, too, is worthy of its own vignette. Penned by Pininfarina, the body is stunning and also a complete departure from its predecessors. And amazingly, it's also functional. At around 125 miles an hour, the body generates 308 pounds of downforce, which is like having Jonah Hill sitting on your car, pushing it into the road. Perhaps just as impressive as the bits you can see are the bits you can't. The underbody, for example, is flat and incorporates air intakes near the back for the radiators. And those radiators are in the rear for a good reason.
The aerodynamics and airflow of the 458 actually push the hot air generated by the radiators into the slipstream behind the car, making it go faster. I know that might sound confusing, so let me put that in more layman's terms. That's like Usain Bolt using the sweat dripping off of him to make himself run faster. Simply staggering.
It doesn't end there. The new roof, which lets sun and sound in, is 25 kilograms lighter than a folding soft top and 40 kilos lighter than the standard fixed hard top on the 458 Italia. If that weren't enough, the Spider, even with its top open, is just as rigid as the Italia, which means drivers don't have to sacrifice driving dynamics for open top motoring nirvana. And out here under the blue sky, you can really appreciate just what that means. Driving a convertible Ferrari in a place like this is normally reserved for the movies. I keep waiting for the symphonic soundtrack that tugs your heartstrings to fade in. Fortunately, Ferrari's conductors have been hard at work.
Ferrari is more than just a car. It's a truly iconic brand. That prancing horse up front is instantly recognizable from here to Singapore to Kinshasa. And just the words Ferrari convertible strike to the heart of any automotive lover anywhere, no matter where they're from. And that's the brilliance of a car like this, of a Ferrari. It transcends any time or culture. It's like Beethoven's Ninth or the Taj Mahal. It's something we can all appreciate.
But of all the things the Ferrari 458 Spider is, be it a gorgeous work of art, an F1-inspired powerhouse, or an engineering masterpiece, it's still a driving machine. And what a driving machine it is. It's out here that you realize the 458 is more than just a car. It's a Ferrari. And Ferrari is a blend of art, engineering, and generations of racing success. There are other race cars for the road out there, but there are harsh, unforgiving objects.
Driving this car, you feel the souls of the people who designed and built it, and the ghost of every Ferrari for the last 8 decades. It's that heritage, that soul, that will ensure 100 years from now, people still look at the 458 Spider in awe. It's like a Renaissance cathedral, designed by Michelangelo and engineered by Da Vinci. And I am so lucky to be behind the wheel of this car, this work of art, if only for a moment, because this Ferrari, it truly is an argument for why supercars should exist.